We welcome you back from the intermission to ECG Universe Mode Revival. I don't think I retitled this video, but I'll just do it later when it gets exported to YouTube. For those of you just joining us, my name is Swerve. Welcome to Elite City Gaming. We want to take this opportunity to remind you that you can follow us on Twitter at ECGTweets. Use the hashtag WeAreElite to keep the conversation going. Give us a like on Facebook, subscribe to us on YouTube, follow us on Twitter, tell your friends, and no matter what you do, guys, make sure you turn on notifications so you always know when ECG is streaming. We want to thank Trivium for Until the World Goes Cold, the official theme song of our incarnation of Global Force Wrestling. We also want to welcome Saurus. And we also want to welcome Connor. And we also want to welcome our audience, including our favorite cast member, Tim Tim. Welcome, audience, and welcome, Tim Tim.
Tim Tim.
Tim Tim! Most popular guy on our channel that isn't us, by far. All right. With that being said, guys, we have the announcement of two new tag teams for TNA. And I'm delightfully embarrassed. Up first is you, me, and Mick Foley, the schizophrenic tag team of Mick Foley and Mankind. And we also have a super faction, Jushin Thunder Liger, Psychosis, Shark Boy, Suicide, Abyss. It's Power Rangers Jr. And the worst part is their fucking names actually sounds like some kind of super squad. Fucking Jushin Liger, Psychosis, Suicide, Shark Boy, Abyss.
Abyss and is like, if this was Guardians of the Galaxy, he'd be like Drax the Destroyer.
Oh, you know what? I want to change this to from Power Rangers to Botcher Rangers.
Botcher Rangers.
So, Botcher Rangers Jr., aka Power Rangers Jr., is now a thing because you needed that in your life and you didn't know it. While we're here, guys, I'm also going to announce a new tag team.
Oh.
It's the reformation of a tag team you didn't know you needed. It is X-Pac, Just Incredible, and Giant Bernard. Ayo, you dealing with the X Factor. It's the reunion you didn't know you needed.
Tim Tim wants Skynet back.
I know Tim Tim wants Skynet back. That's on Connor signing the Terminator. But
he's already he'd need the Undertaker as well.
No, he doesn't. He can form a new Skynet. It's like Terminator Genesis, there's infinite timelines. So the X Factor, the team you didn't know you needed, is back and ready to go. Alright, guys. It is now time to actually do stuff. So it gave me 7 matches. I'm not going to use 7 matches. It's just you can't... actually, real quick. What month do we want to start on?
This month?
You want to start like June or...
Yeah.
Alright, so we're going to start on Money in the Bank month. Alright, that's...
Money in the Bank.
That's fine with me. So let's get up to... currency.
All our titles have changed.
I know, I'm going to have to go change them back. Jeff Jarrett has successfully defended that. And he beat Darren Young to do it. Alright, let me just go make sure all the titles are still the same. I don't think we have any real titles other than the NXT ones. Oh, Seth Rollins won your title. We gotta change that. He really wants to be your champion in like every show that you do.
He's my man.
Put that back. Shit. Team 3D won your tag titles. So we're gonna put that back.
That needs to be back. Fucking
Where the, here we go.
All right.
Sting won that, so we gotta change that back to. Your show's doing some weird shit, my friend.
None of my titles can stay in one place. It's just...
I know. Scott Steiner, Awesome Kong, Trish Stratus. We had rules, and I'm not gonna be the one that breaks them. How many copyright strikes do you guys think we're gonna get for all the Trivium and Shaggy that we've been playing?
So many.
Hopefully not. I have it quiet enough that I'm hoping that it just is like, ah, fuck it, I don't care. Yay, my titles didn't change hands. Except for that one. Alright, so that should be that. And also...
All the tag teams are still there.
Oh yeah, that's important. And no new ones have formed. Nope, everything's Gucci. Alright.
Yay.
So, let's check rivalries. Oh fuck, that's awesome! That's definitely happening. That is not, though. And neither is that. I'll give everybody an opportunity. Alright, Saris. That's gotta go, because it's only got a week. That's gotta go. And that's gotta go. And, Connor, we're gonna erase yours, because I don't think you wanted any of that. Alright. So, Saris, we'll let you set up your rivalries first. So, what would you like to do?
We will have a medium rivalry.
Okay.
For the United States.
Oh, shit. Scott Steiner.
He will go against AJ Styles.
Alright, that'll be weird as fuck to watch. Alright, up next.
For the World Championship.
What length?
Do a short one, it won't last long.
Alright.
I don't think it will. Austin Aries, obviously.
And?
Brock Lesnar.
Oh!
That's why I said it won't last.
Yeah? Alright, and last.
Might as well do a tag one.
What length?
Medium.
Alright. Is it your titles?
It'll be the titles.
Alright, so we've got Nash and Hall, the Outsiders. Oh shit! That's not right. Versus?
There's another team I need to make in a bit. They will face...
I want to see the Power Rangers thing.
The Power Rangers, they will face the team of Liger and...
Psychosis. It has to be those two. Alright! I actually want to see that a little bit. Saris is off to a good start. Alright, Connor. Your rivalries. Alright. If you want, I can give you time to think about it.
Yeah.
Okay. Meanwhile, on my show, I'm just going to reset this. But I want that rivalry. We will indeed be doing Daniel Bryan versus Pentagon Jr. Where is Pentagon Jr.? For the Next Gen Championship. We will also be having Jeff Jarrett will defend the NWA World Heavyweight Championship against Ryback. And a tag team feud of my own. My champions, the Briscoes, will be going up against the Bullet Club.
Oh, shit. While Connor's still thinking, I need to set up the team that totally reeks of awesomeness.
Oh, yeah, I can do that real quick. Ah, I dropped my controller. On TNA, of all places, this is going to be a thing.
Yeah!
Okay, there it is. So, without any further ado, let's get into my first show. Oh, shit. Alright, so, three of my matches are decided for me. So, I will just change this one into my main event, I guess. We're gonna have back-to-back tag matches.
I kinda hate you.
No, we're not. I lied.
They take so long.
We're gonna have a one-on-one women's match. Sexy Star will face Amanda Marks, and I gotta set up this team too. And where's her partner? I don't remember her name. Nicole Beaumont, Team Canada. Now, a quick disclaimer. Stop. A quick disclaimer. I have not had the opportunity to go through and check to see if all of these have, if all of these people have entrances. How do I save this? I've got to be. Can't you save matches and not actually play them? Save right there. Got it. I have not had the opportunity yet, as I said, to check and make sure that all of these people have. Fuck! I just started that match. Well, that's going to be our kicker then. We're going to kick off with this match right here. All right. I've not had the opportunity to check and make sure all these guys have entrances or move sets yet. So we are going to be learning this together. So to, I guess to kick off our show tonight, Rey Mysterio will wrestle Jon Moxley. Because fuck it. That's why. I actually have no problem with this match on a whole.
I may be jumping out midway through your stream.
I also hope this Rey Mysterio isn't a mod, because if it is and it's not going to work, that would be bad. But I don't think it is. I hope it's not. I don't think he has an entrance, so I don't think it's a mod. Let's find out. It is not a mod, yay! And to kick off Global Force Wrestling, here comes Rey Mysterio. Saurus, what are your thoughts?
Rey Mysterio normally does quite well in matches.
that's the most generic thing I've ever heard in my life.
He looks a lot taller.
He might be bigger, who knows. Connor, what are your thoughts?
I don't know
about Mysterio,
he's a tiny guy.
And he does a lot of flippy shit.
Yeah, get things started, man. It's a good one. Even though you accidentally picked it.
Yeah, you know. Okay. And looks like Jon Moxley doesn't have music. So, that's fitting.
Isn't that just Dean Ambrose?
Yes, that's his indie's name. When he wrestled in CZW and other places.
Like when he debuted in TNA that one time.
Yeah. Or that time he was on Velocity back in the mid-2000s.
Is that when he had pink hair?
Yes, he did have pink hair.
Why's
he got Summer Rae's drawn? Whoever made this is one of those kids.
One of those.
Remember when you'd play SmackDown vs. Raw online and all the kids would just make their cause have women's trons and they'd be like, so I can look at it, man. Why would you want to watch a bunch of guys when you could look at the girls? Alright, Mysterio Moxley kicking off our universe mode here. We gotta get to Connor's incorrect prediction of the day. So, Connor, we need you to make your prediction.
I'll go Rey Mysterio.
Rey Mysterio. All right, Saurus.
I'm gonna go Moxley.
Jon Moxley. What about Tim Tim and the rest of the audience out there? We're gonna need your predictions as well. Oh, big booty stomp.
Stepping on the boot.
Stamping on the butt. goes behind and does the kick to the leg thing and the forearm to the back thing. Oh, look out, he's gonna mount him like a dog. Look out! Sunset bomb! Connor, don't you wish you could do that?
No.
Oh, yes, you do.
I wish I could drive. It would probably be a better thing. All you gotta do is learn.
Saris, didn't you just get your driver's license like 3 months ago?
No, I'm still learning.
Oh, okay. You're like SpongeBob and Mrs. Puff. Hey, I just got my license! Hey, I'm getting mine next! Hey, I doubt it! I think the Jabba World Order will attack both of them, so it will end in a draw. Who is the Jabba World Order, Tim Tim? Are you talking about X Factor? Big on the drop!
That he missed.
Hey, Saris, did you know I tried to catch wind yesterday?
Did you miss?
I missed. Flowfry says Ray wins by killing Ambrose. Hey, it's Moxley. Flowfry, I gotta get it right, man. It's John Moxley. It's not Dean Ambrose.
Every time I talk to you, it's just bad puns.
Because it is what it is. Connor, let's tell a joke to Saris and just insult this match by ignoring the moves. Let's tell a joke to Saris that I told you a few weeks ago that had you crying in laughter. Saris, what is the difference between an old bus station that a homeless person has been sleeping on for months and a crab that's been left out in the sun for too long? We got a cover! He got the rope! Ah, oh, the ref! Very observant. So, Saris, what's the difference between those two things?
I don't know.
One is a crusty bus station, and the other is a busty crust station.
That's amazing.
It's totally the only... I'm just surprised that Monday night didn't keep the same ref.
I know. All of these crooked refs that we had have been fired. I have personally overseen the hiring of new refs that will not fuck around with pinfalls like we saw with the Super Luchas, which is ancient history for some now. So we have to get all new storylines going here. Oh, KO out of nowhere! And he slithers into the cover! One, two, and a kick out of two! I didn't expect that. That's not what happens. Uh-oh. He's got him up. Oh, counter by Ray! Here on Global Force Wrestling. You gotta wonder if both of these men are looking for an opportunity to sneak into the next-gen championship title hunt. What do you say, Saris? Cover! One! Two! And a kick out of two by John Moxley.
Well, yeah.
Fucking damn it! You, what are you, fucking Yoshitatsu on commentary over there?
Yes!
Well, yeah. Can we make it a thing where once a night you just surprise me and just say, well, yeah, to a question? Watch out, apron DDT!
Dear.
Great insight there by our ever omnipresent Saris. Well, yeah. I'm gonna get a t-shirt on and just have it say, well, yeah. Put it on you.
If only Adam Rose was still around.
What? Oh yeah, if only Adam Rose. He is, he's a free agent.
Yeah, you've made Adam Rose. No, not Adam
he's
Rose.
In the game.
Who the fuck do I...
No. Oh, misses the dropkick. Oh, he took that like a champion.
I can't even remember the name of my own fucking character, man.
Chase Adams?
Chase Adams!
Yeah. Fucking Adam Rose. God damn, that's insulting to Chase Adams. Oh, wow, nice reversal into the arm rest. Into the headlock there. Look at Mysterio! Going for a suplex! Oh shit, no, he's going for a package power driver! Or a package power bomber, fisherman something. I don't remember what that move is called, unfortunately. Fisherman driver, I think, is... That might even be the Michinoku... Is that the Michinoku driver? Somebody help me. I used to know the name of, like, every single move that had ever been done, ever, and now I don't anymore, and it saddens me.
Oh, yeah,
John Moxley getting spanked around by Rey Mysterio here. Cover!
Chase Adams used to be Adam Starr.
That's why you fucking, yeah. Because you're bad at naming people, and I'm good at naming people. You're good at coming up with concepts, but then you can't name them. You always, like, you'll give them a wolf tattoo, and your name is, like, his name is, like, Wolf Moonlight Jr. Cover! One! Two! No! A kick out of two! And John Moxley can't believe it!
Hey, you can't mess with Connor McCloud.
Duncan McCloud. You tried to have a wrestler once named Sanka, and every time you would just be like, "Cool Runnings, RKO out of nowhere! In the cover! One, two, and a kick out of two! By Mysterio!"
Sanka was amazing.
He never did shit. You had one character die. Sunset bomb into a pin! One, two, and a reversal! One, two, and a reversal! One, two, and a reversal! One, two! No! I was wondering how long that was gonna go. I was really hoping it would just keep going.
Trying to think of some of my other amazingly named characters. Jack Angel, because he had angel tattoos on his back.
And he fucking fell off the roof of the building and died. And he's in the Hall of Fame now. Oh, God!
Oh,
he became Jack Weathers when he joined the New Testament.
We're just
reminiscing about old school CWE, and these guys are like, what the fuck are they talking about? Who are these people? I've never heard of these people. Two! No, another kick out! Rey Mysterio will not die!
He didn't last long. In the New Testament.
The New Testament didn't last all that long.
No, but...
It was a great idea, it just didn't last that long.
Some of the guys went on to do quite well.
Yeah, Eric Matthews is still around, Garrett Hawk is still around, the other two are fired.
Yeah, and Jack Weathers died.
And Jack Weathers died and became the first Hall of Fame inductee because he fell off the roof of the building. And a nice tiger suplex.
Why? Because that's what we wanted to do.
Didn't we just were like, fuck this guy, I gotta get him off the show? And I was like, how many dies? Because that's what 19-year-old me was like would be a good storyline, was that he should fall off the roof of a building and die.
That's what I call booking revolutions.
That is exactly what booking revolution is.
Fuck it, that guy's gonna die. How?
That time we killed Big Bob Orson and they had a coffin at the ringside and fucking somebody put him through the coffin and I was like, that's sick! First of all, why would they bring the coffin? And second of all, why would they put it where they know it's gonna get hurt?
And then we set everything on fire.
We did set it on fire. We had a cremation live on a wrestling show. Oh, look at Ray! Nice counter by Ray, look at him go!
Nice.
Into the corner. So we have... Connor picks Ray. Saris, did you pick?
Yeah, I picked Moxley.
Okay, and Tim says that the X Factor is going to come down and interrupt this match. Flo Fry picked Ray. I'm going to go ahead and pick Moxley. Because he's already hit two RKOs. Cover! One! Two! Kick out of two by Moxley.
I thought that was going to be it.
I would have cried if...
Just you make your...
I pick Moxley! Shit. And Ray wins! Well, fuck.
RKO
out of nowhere! And the crowd chants RKO! And that's it! It's John Moxley! And Connor's incorrect pick of the day remains accurate. As we can now see some of the highlights from this one, Rey Mysterio doing the thing. and then just dragging Moxley.
Sadly, I'm going to have to miss the rest of this.
What?
What?
I got daily dreams and shit.
Why are you so echoey?
Because Connor's a douchebag.
Oh, thanks.
You're so welcome.
I'm echoing through Connor. That's how I'm
That's probably, that probably is what's happening. Man, what did you guys think of that opening match? It wasn't as exciting as I thought it would be, but those RKOs on Jon Moxley are kind of...
Yeah, those RKOs are good. Other than that, reminiscing about CWE was good.
Yeah, reminiscing about arguably the dumbest time in CWE. That time when nothing good happened except for the formation of like two careers. And that was the move that ended the match for Jon Moxley.
Another random point in time around that point was when we had Eric Hellstrom.
Hugo Hellstrom.
Hugo Hellstrom.
And he came down to the ring to fucking Led Zeppelin.
Yeah.
But the Gregorian chant version of Led Zeppelin.
Yeah.
Because why the fuck not, I think, is our overwhelming logic about wrestling.
Fire and then he became Hellstrom and then disappeared.
No, he became Hellfire.
Hellfire. Then got
you don't even remember... You were there for it.
Then got a knee injury and didn't come back.
Flo Fry says, too bad Booking Revolution is played too rarely on Twitch. Don't know if there is even someone other than you playing it. You know what, Flo Fry? I believe to this day thoroughly that the fact that we have been playing Booking Revolution is the sole reason we have any remote level of success. Because I think Flo Fry's right. I don't know of many other people playing it with any success. So
yeah,
we have a claim to fame, boys.
Right, I'm gonna go. I might be back if you're still on in like an hour or so.
Probably won't be, but...
Okay.
Well, thanks for coming and thanks for doing your draft.
That's okay. Bye.
Right. We'll see you later, Saris. So, it is now down to Connor and I. Connor, are you excited?
I am.
Alright, well, it is now time for what should be a good tag match between the Briscoes and the Bullet Club. Are you ready? Well, yeah. Right. Flo Fry says makes sense. I agree. Everything I do makes sense. Like when I jack off the antifreeze, makes sense. I did it.
I did it.
Are you super jacked, Connor?
I wouldn't say super jacked. Just normal.
Right.
Right.
Any moment now. It's loading so much custom stuff that it's struggling. These guys have so many logos on them that it's taken it a bit to load it. Oh, I got a text message. Oh boy. Here we go. Alright. Here come the Pizza Hut Tag Team Champions. It's the Briscoes. Connor, are you excited to see the return of our Pizza Hut corporate sponsor?
Yeah, it never goes away.
I believe that to actually be really genuinely true. If I were to leave some Pizza Hut out on the counter, I don't think it would ever biodegrade. So, well, what I can promise you about this tag team match is that we're about to get a two-for-one deal here.
Oh my god, the puns. I forgot about the puns.
And here they come! Doc Gallows! Carl Anderson! It's the Bullet Club! Now, Connor, are you excited for the Bullet Club, who are the original group that created the Bondage Club in our old stream?
Oh, is that them?
This is the parody. The parody of the Bondage Club, or the Bullet Club was the Bondage Club, so...
so many good things in that.
I know. I miss the old stream. I wish data hadn't gotten corrupted, but you know what? We're going to rebuild better than before. I promise you that. All right. Here we go. The Briscoes and the Bullet Club. Now, Connor, we got to get your incorrect prediction in here.
I'll go Bullet Club.
Bullet Club. All right, that means the Briscoes will win. Although I'm also going to go Bullet Club. Lots of camo in this match. Lots of camo. Center of the corner. Oh. Now, Connor, do you have any big plans upcoming for NXT? Holy shit.
I might see how like my first show or second show go before I do anything.
So you're going to kind of have like a feeling out process.
Yeah.
All right. Do you have any confidence in the guys you've drafted?
I do. Like I said, my wrestling knowledge is subpar at least, so I try to go for big names at least.
So, and there's a tag made. Big elbow. And so far, the Briscoes have done a good job isolating Doc Gallows. And a cover there. One, two, and a kick out by Doc Gallows at two. Did it help to get some familiar faces in there?
It did.
Uh-oh. DDT. And the tag made to Carl Anderson.
So how many matches are you doing? The four?
I got five. If you have to leave at some point, you can go and I will carry the show myself like a trooper. It'll be interesting to see what weird as fuck storylines develop over time here, because that is our forte, is our ability to just sell shit storylines to people. Tag made. I have a feeling also that you drafted John Cena because you intend to try to remake Skynet.
I gotta get at least one of the Terminators.
And you have to get potentially Undertaker.
Well, no, he was after, he was, I mean, Terminator is the OG of Skynet.
Yeah, but Undertaker did all your heavy lifting.
True. I mean, I got like Mark Henry, Kane.
You got some guys you don't even realize would fit. Cover! One! Two! And a kick out of two by the by Doc Gallows. I'm honestly not sure why Gallows hasn't tried to tag out yet. Counter. Jawbreaker. Another jawbreaker with a little more force. To the lower back now. People who watch me do commentary on here would probably never watch CWE, even though I do it totally differently. Cover. Two and a kick out. I'm so hungry, but my mom is bringing some steaks up to my house today. She's bringing my new grill that we bought yesterday. So I gotta wait till like 5 o'clock to eat. Oh, right to the back.
I'm gonna leave my dog out.
And now throws him into the corner. And look out here! Oh, fuck! He lawn darted him into the middle turnbuckle. I didn't even know that move was in the game. That's fucking intense.
Attack.
Carl Anderson now legal. Mr. Anderson. Oh, rake of the eyes. Oh, ducks it. This has actually been a pretty good match. DDT, nice counter. And a cover here by Anderson. One. Kick out. I like how Briscoe and Doc were doing the same thing on the apron. And again, a big counter. And another one. Square to the chops. And now, oh, shoulder breaker.
For a tag. Ooh.
Nice counter. Oh, big knock down there. As the Briscoe's now trying to take advantage. Tag me! Sorry about that. Cover! Two! And a kick out there. Win over the champions here would be huge for Bullet Club, I'd like to believe. And now Doc Gallows sizing up. You got him up! Oh, fuck! And a cover there. One, two, and a kick out by the Briscoes.
So we both picked Bullet Club, didn't we?
I picked Bullet Club, yeah. Oh my god, everybody always wants my attention when I'm doing stuff. Cover! One, two! Oh, and it was broken up! Actually, I think the Jay Briscoe got in there and made the save, and Doc Gallows kicked out anyway. Now tag is Carl Anderson tagged in. Look out. Double suplex. Cover. Two! Oh, it almost got him! Man, Connor, the Bullet Club has really turned this match around. Early on, they were definitely not on top of things, but they're pulling it back now. Look at this! Oh, fuck! Watch out. Oh, nice flying knee. That might be enough. Cover. One. Two. Oh, no, he kicked out. Look at this now. This is broken down a bit. Ooh. I don't know what happened there. Briscoe got him up. That's a Michinoku driver. Right there. Cover! One! Two! And a kick out of 2.9 by Carl Anderson.
Another tag, mate.
The Briscoe's now trying to get it back. I hate trying to do commentary and text people at the same time. Forearm to the back. Stomp to the back. Guess who's back? Back again. Briscoe's back. Oh! Snake-eyed. And now looking for a camel clutch. He's been working on that lower back this whole match. Carl Anderson's going to have to crawl to get to the ropes or just stand up like a champion and slam him down.
Nice counter on that.
What?
Very back and forth.
Yeah, I'd say. Surprisingly so for this tag match. Tag made to Doc. How about Doc fucking gives up the momentum? And Briscoe's just going to spin him. Bear hug, but he's right near the ropes. You'd think Doc would be able to get there. And he counters it into a DDT. And into the corner. Tag made to Carl Anderson. Oh. Uh-oh. Carl Anderson going mental. RKO out of nowhere! Why does everybody do that? One, two, no! Why does everybody on my goddamn show do an RKO? Slams his face down. Slams him into the Slams him into the corner.
Right into the porn.
I couldn't decide whether I was gonna say post or corner, and I said I was gonna say porn. Cover, and he's cheating. One, two, three. The Bullet Club steals one over the champions. The Bullet Club steals one. As Carl Anderson had his feet up on the ropes there. After he viciously slammed one of the Briscoes into the porn. And he was able to get the win by cheating. Connor, we cannot have a situation where people are using porn like a weapon here on Global Force Wrestling. What do you think?
Porn is more of an enjoyable thing. I hate to see it used as a weapon.
I know. Someone who could find such a vile, disgusting way to use porn. Just leaving his opponent in bondage. I like where that replay started, because it looked like Doc just fell down. Now, Connor, we had the bondage club before. You mean to tell me, oh god. Of course we're using the Bullet Club, and I accidentally make a porn reference. And the Bondage Club comes up again.
It's hard to forget Ric Flair and tight leather.
I know, it is very hard to forget that. There, of course, is the cheating by Carl Anderson that got the win for the Bullet Club over the champions. And you've got to think that somebody had their eyes on that one, but if not, the Bullet Club may have just found their end to the tag team titles.
I'd like to see if there's any repercussions, though.
I would also like to see if that is a thing. Because, if not, you can't let these guys just run roughshod. Okay, we move on here on Global Force. Up next, we have Sexy Star versus Amanda Marks. And Mexico will face Team Canada in the United States. I'm actually really proud of Amanda Marks. I worked on her attire a lot. But we'll see how this goes. We're in Boston today. Boston. Okay. And here she is.
So what's with the mask?
She's a luchador.
Oh.
She's Mexican.
So that goes well with the rest of her. Yep.
She wrestles on Lucha Underground. She's actually fucking phenomenal. I strongly encourage everybody out there, if you have not treated yourself to Lucha Underground, what the fuck are you doing? You need to watch this shit. They've got Rey Mysterio. They've got Joey Ryan. So there's names that you know. They got John Morrison. There's names that you know, and even if you don't, the new ones are fucking great. Sexy Star has wrestled many of the guys and put on a hell of a showing. Lucha Underground is just absolutely the shit. It's just so good. Okay. And the flip side. Why the fuck would you have blue lighting if you're from Canada? Because nobody in Canada likes blue. It's always red and white. No other choices. And here she comes, looking very egotistical. Wouldn't you say, Connor?
I would. Hey.
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 How's your breath, eh? Hey.
It's
all hard. You saw that interview, right?
What?
That they interviewed Phil Kessel of the Penguins after that one game in Tampa Bay. And the interviewer was trying to ask him, like, is your conditioning good? You know, like, are you having trouble breathing during games or anything like that? But he asked it by saying, how's your breath? And he goes, how's your breath? And Phil Kessel goes, it's not good, eh? And he's like, no, I meant in terms of conditioning. it's the best interview I've ever seen. All right, Sexy Star versus Alyssa or Amanda Marks. I don't even know the names of the people that I brought to the dance here. I want to have a very strong women's division here on Global Force, and we're going to find out right now if these girls have what it takes. As you know, Layla, our current champion, is going to face a lot of stiff competition. Leg sweep. So now they go into the corner again. Are they just going to stay in the corner? All right, ref. Give me an opportunity to text. I appreciate that, ladies. Oh, fuck! That's ruthless powerbomb. Now, Connor, we gotta get your, oh, shit! Oh, fuck! Dropped her off the top turnbuckle. We gotta get your incorrect prediction of the day in here, so.
Well, I was right the last time.
You were right, but that's because I also picked it, and they cheated. Sit down, jawbreaker.
I go to Team Canada.
Team Canada. Amanda Marks and Nicole Beaumont. Ooh. Well, in corner, I have to pick against you this time and go sexy.
Love it when you go sexy.
I know you do, Connor. This is why the entire staff at our high school thought we were gay.
Yeah.
We are gay.
Thrown into the corner, Sexy Star bounces right off the pads. What?
Coming.
Oh, leg DDT. Oh, nice sweep. Sexy sweep. What is this? Oh, okay. What? Whoa! Whoa now! You were not facing that direction. And she gets out of it. Look out, DDT there. And a cover by Amanda Marks. One. And a kick out by Sexy. Sexy kick out. Oh, right in the tits. Oh, man. You're going to knock the silicone out of those. Anna Marks now just doing the disco. Fuck you, says Sexy Star. Look out. Oh, trying to break the wrist and fingers of Amanda Marks there. Where's she going? Okay, sure. I believe it. I believe. Right in the gut. Nicole Beaumont outside, very pleased. Look out. Oh, counter. DDT. Oh, shit, her legs. Her legs landed up in the thing. Cover. One, two, and a kick out there by Amanda Marks. And a drop kick to the back. And now Sexy going up top. Oh, Sexy Tornado DDT. And the cover. One, two, and a kick out, and Sexy almost gets it. Watch out, clothesline. Oh, that's very mean. Canadians aren't supposed to do shit like that. Sweep! Sexy sweep. Oh, nice arm drag there by Amanda Marks. These women are going to give Layla stiff competition no matter which one of them comes out. I'm not saying this is the number one contenders match, but it certainly would help. Now, Amanda Knox headed outside. Oh shit, Connor! She's coming over here! You, me, and Saris just standing over there. Sexy rolls out. Oh, what? That was a little weird. Knee drop. Right on the mask, absorbing most of the blow. I think that's how physics works. And now gonna drag her. Around and around and around. No direction. Watch out. Over the top goes Sexy. And the stompage. And into the table. Oh, but a counter by Sexy. Sexy counter.
Shut up.
Sexy just watching now, and she jumps back in. Sexy jump back in. Uh-oh, the Sexy's hype up. Into an armbar. Impressive. Armbar locked in here, but she gets out of it. Sexy kick. Sexy forearm. Sexy whip. That's my kind of whip. Puts her up on the top rope. Sexy puts her up on the top rope. Big elbow. She hops down. Amanda Marks wants nothing to do up there. Spinning elbow. Oh, grabs her by the butt. And now they're going to scissor and a face plant.
Sexy scissor.
Sexy scissor. Cover. One, two. Kick out of two by Sexy Star. Ropes. Oh, super kick! What is... Nicole Beaumont on the outside looks like she has fucking food poisoning. Uh-oh. Reversal! Russian leg sweep. And look out. Big elbow. In hockey, that gets you a penalty. And a cover. One, two, and that's it. Off the elbow. Amanda Marks gets the win. You were right once again, Connor. What?
Two for one.
I know. That's, I'm not going to be able to call it your incorrect prediction of the day for much longer. What do you think of my stage there, Connor?
I like the glow.
Thank you. What's funny about the Global Force logo is it's actually a font that I've been using for years, and it's the old font from SmackDown. So I don't know how they got away with that, but... Sexy Star came very close a couple of times there, Clon. You gotta admit, right here with this one, this armbar right here, is a good chance. But it would be this elbow, right to the tits, that put her down.
Put her down.
Like a dog. Like a sick dog. If anybody just put your dog down, I'm real sorry for that joke. And there's Team Canada, hyping up. These Canadian cuties are on their way to a championship, potentially.
I'm gonna get going.
Aww. I gotta do the rest of the show by myself?
Dog's pissing himself.
What?
And my dog's probably pissing himself.
Alright.
Alright.
Well, I'll tell you what we'll probably do then is we'll do this show. When do you get off work?
Actually they called me off, so I'm off today.
What?
I said they called me off, so I'm off today.
Okay, so you could just let your dog out and come back?
I mean, he's gonna be in the room running around.
Well, aren't you just taking him out to piss?
Yeah, but I can't put him back in his crate. He's been in there all morning.
Okay. Well, do you want to finish the show later tonight then?
Yeah, I can do it later tonight.
Okay, then we'll get back to you on that. Well then, folks, we thank you for tuning into, I guess, part one of Global Force Wrestling Episode 1. And we'll see you later tonight for part two.
Yep.
Adios, amigos.